Welcome to What's Inside, the latest Game Informer issue, number 18 in this series that I've been doing. I'm Auckland. If you enjoy my content, please hit the subscribe button, like button, also share with friends if you don't mind. Also, please comment, ask me a question, or comment in general. I'll do my best to answer them. Also, if you don't mind, hit the notification bell down below, and you will be notified when I go live or upload another video. And if you want to become a fan of me, Auckland, then subscribe to the channel, and you will become a fan. I hope so. Alright, this is issue 331. I'm almost caught up to the actual official latest issue. I got, I think, two more to go, I think. Alright, here we go. This one has Immortals Phoenix Rising on the cover. Awesome game. I played the demo. It's really good. Can't wait to get the full game. Someday. Alright. Going inside, here's an advertisement for Zeus in the game. And some other stuff on the other side. The Xbox Series X controller. And the medium game for Xbox. The creepy game right there. Alright, scratch my nose. Here's the index. I'm going to name off some of them. Assassin's Creed Valhalla. Astro's Playroom. Axiom Verge 2. Bugsnacks. Devil May Cry 5 Special Edition. Evil Genius 2. Where's the first one? Final Fantasy 14. Fire Emblem Shadow Dragon and the Blade of Light. Five Nights at Freddy's Security Breach. Hogwarts Legacy. Immortal Phoenix Rising. Little Nightmares 2. Lord of the Rings The Gollum. Monster Hunter Rise, The Medium, Pikmin 3 Deluxe, Resident Evil 8, The Village, Torchlight 3, Watch Dogs Legion, Yakuza Like a Dragon. Alright. Spider-Man, Miles Morales, and the Nintendo Switch over there. And, of course, Pokemon Go, being advertised at the bottom. Play a little bit of Pokemon Go, but not too much. Pre-order plans, which are very hard. It's very hard to order the PS5 and Xbox Series X. Over here is fan art. This is the top 5 fan art. Number 1 is Ellie from The Last of Us Part 2. Looks like it's a clay. Yeah, it's clay. That's pretty cool. I like that. The second one is Zelda. That one is really, really, really cool. 3 is Okami. 4 is, is that baby princess that has the Lumos characters, the star characters from Super Mario Galaxy 1 and 2. And the fifth one is, looks like Poison Ivy, possibly. That Zelda one's cool, and so is The Last of Us. That one's awesome, too. Next gen becomes new gen, or current gen. PlayStation 5 review, hardware, and form factor. A PS5 is so hard to get. There's that awesome controller. Talking about the user experience, performance, controller itself, compatibility, and the verdict. So, they got an A negative. Not too bad. Next next is the Xbox Series X and S review. For performance, user experience. Man, my nose. Okay. Compatibility, controller, and the verdict. And the verdict is B+. Alright, maybe I'll stop in a minute. Jumping higher. NBA 2K. Right there, being advertised. The Platinum Architect. I guess it's the Platinum Trophies that you can get in-game. And there's Mark Cerny, the creator of the PS5. I think he also created the PS4 Pro. And he is a male version of Siri. Sounds just like a male version. It's crazy. Soaring the clouds. Genshin Impact. Stylish success. Which is a free game to play online, but it becomes not free when you pay for in-game currency, microtransactions, actions, all that mess that people complain about all the time. So far, I haven't fell for that yet. Mythology monsters, so it's like God of War, Dracula from Castlevania, Final Fantasy series, Slenderman, monsters like that, and characters from mythology style games. Okay, looking back with Laura Bailey, the voice acting powerhouse reflects on her career defining roles. So she voices Abby in The Last of Us Part 2. That's cool. Matter of fact, there's her character right there. I know it's kind of hard to see, but I'll do my best. Trapped in Isolation. That's pretty much right. Yeah. Moving on. I'll skip over this right here. Alright, here's some merchandise that you can buy. Alright. I want to show this off right here. The Mandalorian Baby Yoda that you can buy. Why not? Alright, here we go. Ascending to Olympus. It's a coverage of Phoenix Rising. Came out for PS5, Xbox Series X and S, PS4, Xbox One, Switch, Stadia, and PC on December 3rd. It's a beautiful looking game. Very, very Zelda-like. Some more pictures. Beautiful game. Very, very colorful. Alright, let's move on to another game. Oh, this is cool right here. This is very cool. How your character is real, real tiny on that platform. And she must be a goddess in her actual form. And you can also have wings and fly around in the game. Highly recommend the game. I'll get it for Switch someday. Split Scream Horror. Because you can play the game with a split screen. I think you switch between two different realities in the game. In the game called The Medium for Xbox Series X and S and PC. It released on January 28th, 2021. As it says in this magazine. Sometimes Game Informer gets their stuff incorrectly. Not right at all. Some screenshots. Hogwarts Legacy. Really looking forward to this. I think it's supposed to be a Harry Potter RPG game. We don't know a whole lot about it. There's been some speculations that it could be open world or something like that. But a lot of mechanics in designing your characters, possibly, or character. we don't have an actual release date for this game, but right now it says 2021 for PS5, Xbox Series X and S, PS4, PS4, Xbox One, and PC. So now you can see them better. That's going to be awesome. Cannot see this game at all, but it's coming out for PC. Not sure if it's out yet. But here you go. And also Little Nightmares 2, PS5, Xbox Series X and S. Those versions are coming later. PS4, Xbox One, PC, and Switch are, I believe, are the ones that are out now. It was released on February 11th. 11th. Creepy side-scrolling game. Final Fantasy 14 for PS5, which is not out yet. I remember it being advertised at one of the PlayStation events. Because it was first advertised for PS5, and it may be coming to Xbox Series X and S, possibly. But right now, it just says PS5 only. That's like with the situation with Final Fantasy VII Remake. So far, it's only on PS4 only. And now it's got a PlayStation 5 upgrade version coming very soon. Next game is Grounded for Xbox Series X and S, Xbox One, and PC, November 10th. There's a screenshot at the bottom. Oh man, my nose. Monster Hunter Rise for Switch, March 26th. That's coming out later on this month. Franchise is loved by fans. Never got into the series, actually. I know they came out with a movie I'm looking forward to watching. Empire of Sin for PS4, Xbox One, Switch, and PC, December 1st. That's already out. And I think it's got a physical release for Switch, and not sure about other platforms. Next is Evil Genius 2 World Dominion for PC, set to release 2021. Some screenshots right there, kind of see them. And at the bottom we got physical copies of some games. The Pathless, Ori and the Will of Wisp for Switch, Guilty Gear, Crypt of the Necromancer, Necro Dancer, Five Nights at Freddy, and Kaz in the Wild Mask. That game looks interesting. Next is another game I cannot pronounce. It's coming out for PS5, Xbox Series X. It doesn't say S, it just says X only. Huh. PS4, Xbox One, Switch, and PC early 2021, so it's probably already out. And I think, if I can remember correctly, this title looks familiar. I think I saw a Nintendo Direct where this game is going to be released as a double pack with two games with a title very similar to that. right there. I may be wrong, or I might actually be right. I'm not sure. Alright, next is some advertisements of some games. They're not out yet. Resident Evil 8, The Village. Overcooked, All You Can Eat, I guess is DLC, or it might be a brand new game, I'm not sure. Five Nights at Freddy's, Security Breach. Where Cards Fall, Fire Emblem, Shadow Dragon, and The Blade of Light. And Renegades, I guess. I don't know that game right there. Renegades. And there's the other ones that I was talking about. There's some more, too. Axiom Verge 2, Werewolf, The Apocalypse, Lord of the Rings, The Golem, Phantom Breaker, and Stronghold Warlords. Here we are at the section of the magazine that ranks the games. Marvel Spider-Man Miles Morales for PS5 and PS4 got a 9. It's pretty good. is it, excuse me, Vintage? Vinsage? I don't know. Is that how you say it? Got a 8.75 for PS4, Xbox One, and PC. The Pathless for PS5, PS4, PC, and iOS got an 8. Screenshot. Next is Assassin's Creed Valhalla. Got a 9.25 for PS5, Xbox Series X and S, PS4, Xbox One, Stadia, and PC. Watch Dogs Legions got a 9 for PS5, Xbox Series X and S, PS4, PS4, Xbox One, PC, and Stadia. There's so many of them to name off. And then it's like my tongue just like gets stuck. It's like, nope, I can't say it. Alright, next is Astro's Playroom, which is exclusive to PS5 and it's a pack-in game. Got an 8. Kind of figured that I would have gotten at least a 9 because a lot of people are loving that game. Even though it's so simple and it's a platformer, a lot of people are loving it. Next is Yakuza Like a Dragon. Got a 9.25 for PS4, Xbox X, Series X, and S, PS4, Xbox One, and PC. Alright. Next is FIFA 21, got a 7.75, PS5, Xbox Series X and S, PS4, Xbox One, and PC. Then Bugsnax got a 7 for PS5, PS4, and PC. I guess not enough people liked it. Pikmin 3 Deluxe for Switch got a 9. Mario Kart 8 Live Home Circuit got a 7.5 for Switch. You play with an actual toy and it uses AR technology tracking with a Nintendo Switch. It's very, very interesting. You have to build a track inside of your heart. Inside of your house, you cannot use it outside, and then you control the cart, either the Mario Kart or Luigi. There's a screenshot of somebody's house. It's very interesting. Okay, next is a page that's got multiple games on it. Devil May Cry 5 Special Edition got 8.5. For PS5, Xbox Series X and S. 7.5 for something of Rise and Ruin. There's some other games as well. Torchlight got a 3. HL21 got 7.5. And some other ones as well. Just can't pronounce some of them. Okay. And at the back of the magazine, the true value of lost and rare games. Okay. I don't know if that's talking about limited run games or you're actually... You lost some games or something. Possibility, I don't know. And that's the end of the magazine. Alright, hope you enjoyed it. Thanks so much. Alright, bye.